Rock, report range status.
Range green.
T-minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go for main engine start. 0 and liftoff.
These are not the best of conditions. But for these knights of the highways, hauling a multi-million dollar spacecraft more than 800 miles is all in a day's work.
You just don't think about the cost of what's back there. You just want to make sure it's safe, it doesn't get destroyed, you don't get destroyed, and you know everybody's safe at the end of the day.
TESS stands for Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite. It's designed to spend 2 years searching for exoplanets. The 16-hour road trip from Virginia to Florida wasn't easy, and protecting this one-of-a-kind spacecraft during its move was vital.
The case gets used for a number of missions. It's mounted on some shock-absorbing bumpers so that we don't see a lot of the road noise getting into the spacecraft while we transit. We don't want any humidity inside. We don't want the temperature to change, so we have an air conditioning system as well. So we're just trying to keep it environmentally stable on the trip. And then we have very sensitive science instruments. So we actually provide a nitrogen purge. We spray nitrogen gas in to make sure that no air gets in contact with some of the sensitive components.
Even though TESS has safely made it to NASA's Kennedy Space Center, the job of keeping it clean is far from over.
TESS has really strict contamination control requirements. So what we've done is created a clean enclosure inside the high bay that acts like a clean room within a clean room, basically.
This is a unique mission full of first-time events that are sure to be a challenge.
TESS isn't like another mission. We haven't done another TESS. This is the first of its kind.
The time has come for this diverse team to put years of planning into practice as they begin the countdown to T0.
We've had a period of hard work that lasted for years, and when we finally get to the point of launch, it's very exciting. This is where the fun begins, after we've gotten through all the early legwork and the planning, that we are actually going to now prepare a spacecraft for launch, and this will be the first launch from the East Coast on a Falcon 9 for a NASA mission.
Building on the groundbreaking discoveries of the Kepler project, TESS has scientists across the world excited about its possibilities.
TESS is probably one of the most interesting spacecrafts that I've ever worked on in my career because of the science it's bringing back down to Earth. It's taking science fiction to science fact.
What TESS is going to do is look around the entire sky around us to find stars nearby, much closer, 10 times closer than Kepler.
The really exciting part about this is it's the first all-sky survey of this type, using the transiting method to look for Earth-sized and super-Earth planets.
I think the real interest by the public in exoplanets is that everyone has a dream that there is an Earth analog out there, another planet that has the ability to have an atmosphere and water and sustain life on it. That, of course, is the ultimate sort of goal of exoplanet science.
As the science community eagerly awaits launch, the countdown to T0 is now underway.